Hello, Stat 6. Welcome to our today's social studies lesson, whereby our topic will be resources and economic activities. So we start by asking ourselves, what are resources? So resources are things that we use to meet our needs and get wealth. So resources are the things that now we use to meet our needs and then we get wealth. And now examples of these resources include what? We have things like water, soil, minerals, animals, and manpower. So that is what we call resources. Then what are economic activities? Economic activities are the things that now we do to earn money, or the things we do in order to get money. And these things now are like agriculture, we have mining, fishing, trade, transport, and communication. So in our lesson today, we will only focus on agriculture, and it is now agriculture in Eastern Africa. So what is agriculture? Agriculture is the cultivation of crops and rearing animals. That is keeping of animals and growing of crops. That is what we call agriculture. So and agriculture also, we have now some terms used like cash crop farming. So what is cash crop farming? This is growing crops for sale. Cash crop farming is growing crops for sale. We have subsistence farming as another term used in agriculture. Subsistence farming, this is growing of crops mainly for food or for consumption. Growing of crops for food or consumption is what is called subsistence farming. Then we have mixed farming here, whereby now mixed farming is growing and keeping of animals. That is growing of crops and the keeping of animals at the same time in the same land or in the same area. That is what we call mixed farming. So in this subtopic, agriculture, we have now various areas where we will look at. One is the growing of coffee in Kenya and Ethiopia. We have growing of maize in Kenya and Tanzania. Growing of banana in Kenya and Uganda. We have also sisal in Kenya and Tanzania, sugarcane in Kenya and Sudan, and then bee farming in Kenya and Tanzania. So today, we will only look at coffee in Kenya and Ethiopia. So we have the growing of coffee. So we have the types of coffee grown in Eastern Africa, the type of coffee grown in these two countries, Kenya and Ethiopia. One of them is called Arabica, and the other one is Robusta. Among these two now, we have the Arabica is the one that produces the best quality. The Arabica coffee is the one that produces the best quality. Then we have the Robusta that now produces the low quality. So, what are conditions necessary for growing of coffee? What are the conditions necessary for growing of coffee? One of these conditions is heavy or moderate rainfall. So the areas where coffee is grown or where you want to grow coffee, that area should have a heavy and moderate rainfall. Then we have temperatures ranging between 14 degrees and 26 degrees. So these temperatures are supposed to be a little bit low, not too high. That is the temperature ranging between 14 degrees and 26 degrees Celsius. Then high altitude, areas where coffee is grown is of high altitude. We have fertile, deep and well-drained soils. Also, coffee now requires fertile and deep and well-drained soils. Then protection from direct sunlight, and this is especially when they are young. The little crops, immediately they are transplanted into the farms, they are supposed to be protected from direct sunlight. So areas where coffee is grown, we have in Kenya, the areas of Kiambu, Murang'a, Embu, Meru, Kirinyaga, and Tharaka Nithi. So those counties, around those counties, that is where the coffee is mostly grown. Then in Ethiopia, we have Kaffa province and Aral. These are the two areas where now coffee is mainly grown in Ethiopia. So What are the contributions of coffee to the economy, or what are the benefits of this coffee? There is earning of foreign exchange. When this coffee is exported, the countries earn foreign exchange. Then we have source of income for farmers. The farmers who grow coffee get money from this coffee after they harvest and take to the factories and sell there, they get some income. Then there's creation of employment, that is creates employment. So there are workers who work in the farms, the workers who work in the factories, so all those people get employment there. So we have development of infrastructure as another contribution of coffee. Development of infrastructure whereby now the areas where the coffee is grown, these areas need good roads for the transportation of this crop to the factories and also to the markets. Then industrialization, that is growth of coffee-related industries. There's growth of coffee-related industries. And lastly is that it promotes international trade. Most of the coffee is exported, so and that's how it promotes international trade. So that is that for today. You'll get more of the notes in our Summer Plus app. Have a good